They once traveled endlessly across the fields of Kentucky. Stone walls marched across the bluegrass and stood strong without mortar. They were built by immigrants in the traditions of Ireland, England, and Scotland. It's a history dry stone masons, like Mark Martin, are helping to rebuild.
The earliest examples that I've been able to see have been in the Orkney Islands that go back 5,500 years. That's older than the pyramids.
In Kentucky, the rough walls gently divided one neighbor's property from another's.
It began as strictly a functional means of separating your fields when wood wasn't available.
Only about 5% of Kentucky's original rock fences remain.
Over time, those walls began to deteriorate, and with the advent of the automobile, a gravel road bed or macadam was highly sought after. So somebody invented a wonderful rock-crushing machine that would go down the dirt roads and was in a handy position for people to chuck the rock fences right into the grinder.
But these fences are new, built by Mark Martin.
Let's go.
When Mark first left Ohio for the Appalachian Hills of Kentucky, jobs were scarce. Necessity set his feet on the path to stone.
20 years ago, I came to this area, and what work was available was working as a mason's helper.
He found he had an affinity for rock. 5 years ago, Mark gave up mortar for the strength of dry stone. Time destroys mortar with freezing weather, water damage, and moving earth. But dry stone shifts with the seasons. This afternoon, Mark is working on a driveway entrance in Kirby Knob. It's a freestanding wall of Kentucky sandstone, a material of challenging shapes. The wall is nearly halfway up, so he's laying the through stones, which weigh about 50 pounds each.
It's crucial that you get perfect contact all the way across the wall, because this is what holds your wall together.
He perfects that contact by wedging in smaller bits of rock.
You want to get as many pieces underneath that little fellow as you can get.
Mark starts surrounding the three through stones with more face stones. He selects them carefully, as if this is a jigsaw puzzle and the right piece must be here somewhere.
It's one stone at a time. You just have to work one stone at a time.
Sometimes even the right piece can use a few adjustments.
The fun is making little ones out of big ones and fitting them up, putting them, organizing them, creating a little harmony out of chaos.
He fills the gaps with tiny odds and ends of rock called hearting.
Hearting is properly named because it's the heart of a wall. If you don't put the hearting in properly, that wall is just not going to stand.
That's because over time, freezing and thawing can cause rocks to shift, turning small gaps into big voids. That can cause a wall to collapse.
We do some rock fence repair, and many times when you approach a tumble-down section, you'll find virtually no hearting.
It's clear the design makes this wall stronger than just any pile of rocks.
We're going to put another 800 pounds of stone on top of each one of these through stones, and that is really going to cement that wall together without the use of concrete.
It will take more than a week to finish this back-breaking, rock-breaking...
So much for that.
...labor. The wall on the other side of the drive is nearly complete. Mark has laid a broad layer of capstones atop the two faces. Now he's topping that with a row of coping stones.
Functionally, what it does is it puts the weight of four stones on one capstone.
With them, Mark caps off a new chapter in Kentucky's rocky history.
It's going to stand the test of time. This wall will be here for 150 to 200 years, as is.
An amazing feat, since there seems to be nothing holding it together.
it's built not with fixatives and glues. It's built with the skill and the patience and the strength of the mason who built it. So he really puts a part of his life in each wall.
In an age of technology, Mark Martin is helping revive a tradition born in the old country and reared in the heart of old Kentucky.